Students, let us do the exercise of chapter 1, matter and its composition, given on page number 12. Let us do the objective ones first. We tick the correct choice. Number 1, a substance has a fixed volume, a free surface, but not a fixed shape. The substance is a option B, liquid. Matter exists in the form of D option, all of these. Which of the following can be easily compressed? Option A, hydrogen. Which of the following has the least intermolecular space? Option B, iron. Now, number C, fill in the blank spaces in the following statements. The three states of matter are solid, liquid, and gas. Second, gas can flow in all directions. Number three, a solid has a definite size and a definite shape because the forces between its molecules are very strong. A liquid has weaker forces between its molecules and so does not have a definite shape. Number D, true or false type questions. Number 1, solids are highly compressible. False. Second, in solids, the constituent particles are fixed to their positions. True. Number 3, in gases, the intermolecular or cohesive forces are absent. True. Molecules are made up of atoms. True. So now let us start with the question answers. Answer the following questions. First one, what is matter? Give the states of matter with an example of each. First answer, what is matter? Anything that occupies space and has mass is called matter. I repeat, anything that occupies space and has mass is called matter. Second part of the question is, give the three states of matter with an example of each. So three states of matter are solid, liquid, gas. Give an example of each. Solid, you can give any example. Here I have written pen. Second, liquid, water. Example of gas is air. Question number 2. On the basis of position of particles, how will you differentiate between the three states of matter? So the second answer, solids. In solids, the particles are fixed. In liquids, particles can move to a little extent. Whereas in gas, particles can move freely in all directions. I repeat the answer once again. Solids, in the solids, the particles are fixed. In liquids, particles can move to a little extent. In gas, particles can move freely in all directions. Now, question number 3. With the help of an activity, prove that a stone has mass and occupies space. Now, this answer is clearly given on page number 10. Point number 1. First experiment which is given, that one is the answer to question number 3. Next is question number 4, that is, what is an atom? Does it exist independently? So the answer to it, an atom is the smallest unit of matter that exhibits all the properties of matter. I repeat, an atom is the smallest unit of matter that exhibits all the properties of matter. Now, the second part of the question is, does it exist independently? So, the answer to it is no. An atom cannot exist independently. So, this way I complete the first chapter.